talk about functionality in CSS. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, this is basically how it works. We have checkboxes for click events, and then we have ready buttons for states. And with a transition delay, we can control the persistence of a state. So what I'm going to show you is a simple app that I wrote in pure CSS. It's basically going to have a few radio buttons on top. And then we have a div, which is going to be our app. Now, the radio buttons need a unique ID and a class name, while they share the same name. So they're all connected, so I can toggle between those. Inside the app, I want to put some labels. And they're connected to the radio buttons with the for attribute, and they also have the same class name. So now if I click on one of these labels, I can actually check the radio button that's outside. And I can then get some functionality inside the app. So with the tilt selector, which you can imagine that's sitting right here, we can now say if the second one is checked, for example, in this case, we want to highlight the label that is selected. The next step is to put some kind of pixel grid inside the inner element. Okay, so we have a lot of divs inside this inner element, and each div will represent a pixel. Each pixel is going to need a transition on the background color, and we don't want to have a duration on this one, but we want to have a really long delay. So if we now change the color, it's not going to change back for a really long time. Obviously, we want to change the color at a certain point, and that's if we hover a pixel. So while we hover the pixel, we just set the transition delay to zero. Now we have the tilt selector, and with this one, we can't only focus on the labels that we created, but also inside the inner div. So now for the second case, we want to set the background color to green if we have the pixel. This is basically what it looks like. The green one is selected. Now if we hover a pixel, we can actually draw a line or multiple lines with our mouse. And now if we select the orange one, we can draw with orange. This is the prototype that I made. I also added the hardness of a brush by setting the transition duration to maybe 30 milliseconds, then 60, and so on. And this is something I drew. It's done in pure CSS. The functionality is in CSS. The drawing is in CSS. I hope that makes a smile. And if we were to connect a color picker that's also made in pure CSS, we could get the full range of colors. If you're interested in stuff like that, you can view my stuff on CodePen. I have a memory gain, a slot machine, stuff like that. It's a lot of crazy stuff. It's codepen.io/pixelass. And on Twitter, I'm at Gregor Adams. Thanks.